Good evening, and thank you for coming to tonight's concert. We are the Limestone College Wind Ensemble, and we are presenting folk tunes and hymns tonight. Started off with Commando March by Samuel Barber, a very important American composer. Samuel Barber wrote for many different types of music, orchestra, choral, and wind. And this work was just one of his inspirations of playing a dichotomy, what we just heard there. A lot of two different rhythms playing against each other, but it just works in such a wonderful way. And like many wind band concerts, we like to start off with a march, and thus Commando March. The next work is much more of a folk tune. In fact, it's a Welsh folk tune by Ray Fonlams. I hope you enjoy this work.
Thank you.
This next work we're going to do, we actually are part of a larger commissioning body. There was roughly 60 high school and colleges that came together to form a consortium to ask the composer, Greg Reeves, to come up with a new wind work, and we're very proud to be part of that tradition at Limestone College of creating new art. And so this is a brand new work, and this will be its premiere. You are a part of history, or the future, however you want to look at that. And this is a premiere of this work, and we're going to play a short video that the composer has put together for you to explain the actual piece and how it came together and what you're about to hear. He'll go over a little bit of the score. So we're going to dim the lights on the stage here. If you give me just a second to get that all put together, we will have this short video for you, and I hope you enjoy that, and then we're going to tune and perform this work.
I'm Greg Utes. I teach music composition here at PLU, and I also have the great luxury and joy of teaching some world music classes, and in fact doing a lot of study abroad with students. And what's nice about that here at PLU, Liberal Arts University, is that I get to mix all these things up together, and it all influences my music. So this is the score. It's based on this Lutheran chorale tune, which in English we know best as O Sacred Head Now Wounded. Selecting this one tune, I was thinking about the title, O Sacred Head Now Wounded, and I was thinking about all the people who've been waiting at home all these years while their loved ones were in harm's way in various war theaters in the Middle East and Central Asia. So in this piece, this tune takes on this quality of beginning in a kind of a wistful, lonely sort of way, as though your thoughts are just beginning to think about this person. You're going through your daily life, but you constantly have this preoccupation of the danger that your loved one is in. And we hear snippets of the tune, and then there's some sort of ghostly things that come in, and then some saxophones begin playing the tune in a very beautiful way, but then it's sort of taken over by the brass in a dark, threatening way. Almost as if anxiety is sort of welling up and then receding again. And we hear the beautiful saxophones again, but again surrounded by sort of ghostly stuff. And then we get a kind of a crushed, sort of stomped version of the tune, as though it's almost in pain, almost in danger, played in the trumpets. And finally, after a number of times, we get the full band sort of howling out this chorale tune in Bach's most extreme harmonic setting of it. And there are bells ringing, and things are almost flying out of control, and then suddenly, whack, that all stops and just rings. And in the silence, we hear the saxophones again, and the upper woodwinds, and the ghostly things. And then finally, we get to hear what we've been waiting for the whole time, which is the beautiful version, that which sort of brings peace, brings calm, but there's still ghostly wisps around it. And then finally, at the very end, we're left with just kind of vague echoes, and we're almost back at the beginning of the piece, and the last thing we hear in the percussion is just this gong that just rings and leaves us with this sort of ambiguous, questioning mood.
yes? Say yes.
Yes.
I was invested, that's for sure. It's just really fun to introduce new work, and this really was, I mean, as you can tell, that's a tough pill to swallow, both just emotionally and just entertainment-wise. I mean, that's not a song that you're going to go humming out in the streets afterwards, I'm sure. But it was a challenge for our students to grasp, not because of notes and rhythms. They were well beyond that. It was just the concept of putting it together, all these small little parts. As you heard the composer talk, just a lot of little thematic material. We only got the chorale and small little blocks. So it was really neat to try to work out all the issue, work out all the problems, and really put together something new. There was no going to the internet and hearing it and then reproducing it or anything like that. It was just based off of really digging in, and we started this journey way back in January, and of course you just witnessed the premiere. So thank you for being a part of that. So it was really just a lot of fun, and we're looking forward to doing a lot of those, being a part of commission works and just introducing new music, and that's something I hope to bring here to the Limestone, as this is my first year here as director of bands, and it's, I should have said, it's my pleasure to be here tonight as director of bands, and I'd like to thank my department head, Dr. Gina Puvey. I know she's out there somewhere. Oh, there she is, hello. And she is doing a wonderful job with the Department of Music. I also have Dr. Chip Hill is on the stage here playing clarinet with us tonight. And another faculty member that'll come up later in the second half of the program, Dr. David Thompson. So can we give my faculty a round of applause? They're awesome. And since you're applauding, let's have another round of applause for that performance, please. That was fantastic. Thank you, guys. Awesome. Okay, we're going to close the first half of our program with an amazing work. This is Edvard Grieg's only piano concerto, but it made him extremely famous. Composer of Norway. Of course, this is brought to you with our guest. A friend of mine. I used to teach at Claflin University down in Orangeburg, South Carolina. And we were going to collaborate and do this work there because we were very excited to get together and do this work, and it was going to be a lot of fun. And then I took this job. So here I am. So what I did is I called her up and said, hey, you still been practicing it? You still ready to go? And she was like, oh yeah, we're ready to do it. So invited her up to do this, and it is my pleasure and honor to introduce her. She is the professor of piano pedagogy at Claflin. She teaches privately as well as class piano, and she teaches other courses as well. She's been doing research across South Carolina, performing the works of African-American composers in wind band and for piano and for choir. She's been doing a lot of research presenting that material and performing, of course, on piano. But tonight she's going to perform the first movement of the Edvard Grieg Piano Concerto in A minor. It's my pleasure to bring on stage Dr. Ung Jong Che. One more time for Dr. Che, please. One more time.
Thank you.
We are going to take a short break to reset the stage. Please don't run away. There are laboratories in the lobby. We'll be right back in about 5 minutes. We just have to reset the stage. Thank you so much. Our second half of the program, we're really focusing on folk tunes. And folk tunes, as well as hymns, have really influenced the wind band medium, which isn't more than really 100 years old. I mean, there are several instances in the past, prior to 100 years, of course, wind band music and writing, but it was really born of orchestral writing, and the winds were kind of used in small groups or used to promote the larger orchestral works or to accompany voices or that sort of thing. And there are plenty of incidents, but really, especially in this country, it really took off in the early 1900s with marches, which is the other big influences, and folk tunes. A lot of composers were using their native lands and influences to inspire them to write tunes. And this second half, you will hear four large pieces for wind band based on folk tunes. And we start with Variations on a Korean Folk Song.
Thank you.
Shenandoah by Frank DeKelly has become one of the big, big standards for high school bands, college bands, really, any band. It's just a wonderful representation of the work, of the tune. And Frank DeKelly is one of the premier composers for wind band currently. He is really writing a lot of music that's being performed all over the world. And he's really become one of the wind band kind of big names. Someone who represents real fine craftsmanship, really fine understanding of the language of wind band, and really just presents it in a very, I wouldn't say unique way, but definitely you know it's a DeKelly piece when you hear it, if you're used to that language that he's presenting. And it's just really wonderful. And he can write simple tunes like this, folk tune, and turning it into a wonderful piece for band. I hope you enjoy Shenandoah. I know it is Gabe Hill's favorite tune.
Thank you.
So you notice I always point to the flutes for the solos and never anyone else. Well, the band hates me for that because I can't see very far. And that's the flutes are the only people I can see. So whether they have a solo or not, I always point them out. It's a joke, you can laugh. So our next tune takes us to Japan for a Japanese folk song. This is another composer who is writing a lot for wind band and another person that's definitely creating his own language. His ballads are played, and this warm sound that he's found. He really understands how to get a nice warmth out of the ensemble. And this is a story that you can read in the program of love and love lost. And it's a really neat little tone poem that we're going to perform. And this is Japanese folk song.
Thank you.
I'd like to take a moment to thank all the community members. Community members, do you mind standing up for a moment and just being recognized? All the community members that are playing, all of you. Yeah, please, thank you. Can we have a round of applause for all? They really threw out our ensemble and gave us the best of the evening and really gave us the experience. So thank you guys so much. Thank you so much. It just helps to have the full experience, and we are, of course, building our wind band program, and it is getting bigger and bigger every seemingly second, and that is exciting. But I thank the community members for being here and adding their wisdom and experience and really giving us the proper depth that these pieces are asking for. So thank you. We're going to close our concert with Puzza. It's actually four movements, so hold your thunderous applause until the last movement. This is based on a bunch of gypsy dances, and it's just a wonderful expression of this language. So here are Van der Roos and Puzza.
Thank you. Thank you.